This isn't a normal person. It's actually a ghost. Do you believe in ghosts? Or rather, what do you feel about paranormal activities? Some people have taken it upon themselves to go hunting for ghosts or even documenting their finds, which are mostly freaky, if not always freaky. If you ain't afraid of no ghosts, now you sure as heck will be after hearing these creepy stories of people claiming to have encounters with the supernatural. The stories here aren't fabricated and are sure to bring chills down your spine. Number 10, George Washington, Ghost. According to one Imgur user, the ghost of the first American president appears to have recently showed up on a bedroom wall. Didn't believe my girlfriend when she said she saw a face on the wall, Imgur user Mahurtma wrote on the post. Then I took a picture of it. Some Imgur commenters think it's the spirit of Albert Einstein, while others are sure it's definitely George Washington. Either way, those are two pretty cool ghosts to be haunted by, right? Number 9, little girl photobombed in Japan by what people call the ghost of a samurai. The nation of Japan has a long tradition of ghostly phenomena and at times absolutely bonkers paranormal folklore. Included amongst the many tales of ghosts and phantoms of Japan are those of ghostly samurai, those proud warriors of yesteryear who seem to be just as proud and ferocious in death as they ever were in life. A little girl was photobombed in Japan by what people call the ghost of a samurai. While innocently minding her own business and posing for a vacation picture at a Japanese burial ground, this little Canadian girl appears to have awoken what some think is the spirit of a dismembered samurai warrior. The dad who took the photo, which was then posted to Reddit by his friend, claims that no one else was around when he snapped the photo, or so he thought. Number 8, old photo features girl ghost. When Anastasia was flipping through an old family album, she stumbled across a photo of herself playing with her pet birds when she was 4 years old. In the background was another girl holding what looks to be a stuffed animal. But the crazy part is, Anastasia says there was no other little girl there when the picture was taken. Well, not living at least. Her parents also confirmed that they had never seen that child before. And as if this story wasn't creepy enough already, Anastasia allegedly was later told by a psychic, without being prompted, that the spirit of a young girl was following her. Number 7, a ghost allegedly crashed this couple's wedding. It's not uncommon for a wedding to have a few interlopers. That rude cousin who thought it would be okay to bring an uninvited date, or your Aunt Hildy who didn't get the no kids allowed memo. But this couple had the most concerning crasher of them all, one who wasn't quite living. Reddit user KMD All Day and his wife posed for this adorable photo on their big day, thinking nothing of it. But when the bride made her sweet snap her Facebook profile photo, a friend pointed out who, or should we say what, was lurking mischievously in the background. Whether it was the flower arrangements or the music that set him off, one unhappy ghost made sure that the bride and groom knew he wasn't having any of it. As you can see from one Reddit user selfie, there appears to be a rather displeased face lurking in the background of what is an otherwise adorable memento. Grimacing ghost or not, one thing is for sure, the photobomber certainly didn't receive a wedding invitation. Number 6, ghost wandering around Disneyland. We all love a good scare around Halloween, but this footage may be a little too creepy for some, as a ghostly figure can be seen wandering through the closed Disneyland parks at night. Reflections from the light? Luck? Walt Disney himself? Who knows? Whatever the explanation may be, the security footage of what appears to be some kind of spirit lurking around Disneyland will definitely spring goosebumps on your arms. You can check out the clip yourself and pay careful attention to the faint, shadowy figure walking along the path. Number 5, Claude Monet, Ghost. One museum unintentionally became a spine-tingling attraction after documenting a mysterious figure within its walls. As staff for the Cleveland Museum of Art was excitedly preparing for a special Monet exhibit, Jeffrey Streen, the museum's director of architecture and design, snapped a picture capturing an uncanny resemblance to the French Impressionist painter Claude Monet. We thought it was such a coincidence that on the final day of installing painting the Modern Garden, Monet to Matisse, this man resembling Claude Monet was seen peering down into the lower lobby outside the special exhibition hall, said Kelly Notaro to the media, who is a communications associate. This snapshot taken by a staff member is not retouched or photoshopped, and we have heard from other members that they've seen the man, but there hasn't been a confirmation of his identification. In the photo, we see a man with a long white beard wearing a hat, looking distinctly like the famous artist. This is the first exhibition leading into our centennial year, so we are excited to start it off with something as cool as capturing a photo of this Monet lookalike standing directly above an actual photo of the artist himself, said Notaro. After Strand posted the picture on his Facebook page, many commented that it could be the ghost of Monet watching over his work. This isn't the first time the museum has witnessed unusual activity. According to their blog, other artists have come to keep an eye on their work long after their death. It has been reported that the person in this painting, portrait of Jean-Gabriel Duthiel, at the signing of the Treaty of Vienna by Jacques-André Joseph Avede, has been seen in the gallery standing in front of the work, gazing at his likeness, reads the site. Number 4. Spirit of a famed crossdresser. On a visit to New Orleans, Ian Rin and April Russ stopped by Tujo's, which has the distinction of being the city's second oldest restaurant. While they were there, they snapped a selfie, as any good tourist would do, but when they look back, they realize they got quite the souvenir from their meal. Hovering behind them, you can see what appears to be a glowing apparition, or as Poppy Tucker, author and radio host of Louisiana Eats, nonchalantly put it, what you're looking at is Julien Eltinge, Tujo's crossdressing ghost, of course. Tucker explains that Julien was a famous actor of the silent film era who once starred alongside Rudolph Valentino in Isle of Love, which is sadly not available on pay TV. In addition to being quite the thespian, Julien, a crossdresser whose alter ego was Vesta Tilly, also had his own makeup line. He would dine at Begg's restaurant, which later became Tujo's. Tucker said Etienne autographed a picture and gave it to Madame Beau. This photo hung in the restaurant on the wall since 1917. 2 years ago, however, Mark Ladder, the current owner of Tujo's, took down the framed photo of Julien when he was making some renovations. The picture was relegated to the attic, but apparently Julien wasn't too pleased with this move, so he made himself known when Ian and April struck a pose in front of the wall that used to hold his portrait. Tucker advised the owner to get that dang photo back to its rightful place. I said, Mark, get the photo from out of the attic and hang it back on the wall. The ghost is angry and wants to be back in the room, Tucker said. Ever since the photo went back up, the ghost is at peace, Tucker said. Well, lesson learned. Don't mess with a dead diva. Number 3. Ghost haunts this woman's new home. As a new home buyer, there are a few items you should check off your list before making the big purchase. Is the plumbing up to code? Does the house smell like someone else's dog? Oh, and does a man who lived in the 1870s dwell there? The bone-chilling image shows what appears to be a ghostly figure of a Victorian man staring menacingly out the window from the inside of her new home. Mom of one, Michelle, was at the home with her 2-year-old daughter when she went outside and took a picture of the front of her house to share with friends on her Facebook page. She was reviewing the snap when she noticed the man's face peering out of her window. She quickly ran inside to see who was inside her house, only to discover no one was there. I went outside and took a picture, but after initially admiring the brickwork, the face just sort of jumped out at me. I ran into the house to make sure no one was in there because I knew everyone else was at work, but it was just me and my 2-year-old daughter, she said. After studying the photo for a while, she did what any reasonable person would do. She put the picture on Facebook to see if the internet could come up with an explanation as to how the face could have gotten there. She said, most people thought it was a reflection of the flowers below the window, but the angles are all wrong. It's hard to believe, but it clearly looks like the face of an old man. Michelle vehemently denies claims that she doctored the photo. She also said that since then, she's noticed other ghostly ongoings. I'm a non-believer of ghosts, but the picture coupled with a clock randomly falling off the wall and smashing to pieces that morning did creep me out, she said. Michelle says, I'm a very logical person, but I cannot come up with a logical explanation for this photo. It's just spooky. And to be honest, I would rather not think about it as we already hear strange scratches on the walls, noises from upstairs, and lights flicker on and off too. Local historian Andrew Jones, who has studied Samuel Kent's life extensively, said that old man Kent was originally a suspect in the 1860 Road Hill House murder, but his daughter Constance was arrested and eventually convicted of brutally murdering his 3-year-old son. He has every reason to believe that the shadow that's been lurking in Michelle's new home is the spirit of this troubled man. The Road Hill House murder case was later brought back to modern minds by Kate Summerscale's award-winning book, The Suspicions of Mr. Witcher. Care for a read? And with that, it's now time for today's best pick. Today's photo was sent to us by a subscriber, so if you come across a photo online and want to know more details about it, just send it over to us. We might even feature it in a future video. Number 2. The man at the train station. The image shows a man at a train station, but his face isn't visible in the frame. The image has been used in several articles talking about paranormal activities, so it is without a doubt that the figure of the man we're seeing in the image is nothing but a ghost. However, the main story behind this picture is to represent the story of a young man called Karan who took away his life in one of the cabins at Indore Railway Station. The cabin has since then been abandoned at night with no clear justification. Could his ghost still be lurking? What do you think? Number 1. Hospital security camera captures human soul leaving dead body. An eerie CCTV video made rounds on the internet, and it appears to show what many are claiming is a human soul leaving a dead body. The footage, which was filmed years ago in an unnamed Chinese hospital, shows what looks like an awful lot like a humanoid fog floating up and away from a dead body, only to disappear down a darkened hallway. According to what little information surrounds the short CCTV clip, the woman laying motionless on the gurney had been recently pronounced dead with a sheet draped over her body. Not surprisingly, there's been plenty of theories attempting to debunk the footage, ranging anywhere from moss fluttering in front of the lens to an outright CGI hoax. The internet is rife with ghostly CCTV footage videos of entities attacking people, trashing homes, and haunting old hospitals. But unfortunately, quite a few of them are pretty obviously fake. Though, it's hard to be convinced that this is a legitimate video of a human soul leaving a body and disembarking on the journey to the other side. The footage is still somewhat compelling. Getting the chills yet? If you never believed in ghosts, do you think otherwise now?